Hey guys, it's Esther here, and today, well, I was just going to do like a little video of, well, what kind of stuff has been going on. And lately I've been going upon tractors and trains a lot. So first things first, we'll get over to my little layout I've been building 2 days. Just a little piece of cardboard at the bottom, cardboard for that. With a track. Okay, I did not want to use my gray track over here. But right here, what the dirt is from is actually, it's pretty weird. My mom's dad's car, since they track dirt inside the garage, I just decided to, you know, I'm just grab a little brush and a little pickup, But I decided just to put it in a paper plate. Blow dry it, spread it across it, put Elmer's glue on the bottom, and then what I'm gonna do now is, I mean, you can see the Elmer's glue right there. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna let this stuff dry out, see if I can get some like spray glue, just get some spray glue and spray both the sides, and that's that. And also next of all things, let me see my workstation, that's how it's doing. You see my new end. Improved layout. My layout before was not that good. Okay, so as you can see my DigiTrack controller. You see my Burlington Northern. I think it's a Python. I think it's. Focus. You can see that. My little locomotive. Oh jeez, that's not good. I just dropped off place on the track for us for now. Alright, okay. Plug in. Okay, so as you know, as my original layout was basically it consisted of just one of these switches, and it has three switches. That one is not a Bakken switch, that's an actual. Listen forward. Oh, that's. And you know, the Union Pacific locomotive. And I think that just maybe have. Okay, we're just gonna take this one off the track for right now. Okay, so now we're gonna go. So to get. Okay, so we're gonna do the complete tutorial. Yeah, let me. So if you wanna try to find your locomotive source. So what you wanna do is you wanna click. So this is gonna be 000 at the beginning. So what you wanna click if you wanna do DC. Just DC, which means you can collect 00. Then that's actually green. Yep, it's right there. But then I'm right now running a DCC, which is digital command control. Click that again. Go 03. This is just for right off the bat running. Click that. It's green. Green means ready to go. Got the track connection. And track connection, you switch off. Switch it back on. Got brake, forward, and reverse. Also got number one, so it's on brake right now. Think that for a while will slow down. There's that new control and all that. Here's my old controller. It's an old Bakken controller. I got it at a train show. Yeah, I think I got this for $25. $25. And then, well, and the thing was actually starting to go out on me. So what happened was, whichever way that the track was going at, it would always just go slow in reverse or slow forward. So I took it apart. Some stuff looked like it was burned out. Oh, it overheated really badly. So that was not good. So then, we went to my local hobby store. Chicago town. They own a dog for that. He's a railroader. And they said they do ditch or track. I'm like, you know, ditch track might be good. And then I'm like, okay, so. Because I was looking at, I had Bachman. Got a new Bachman set for Christmas. It broke right off the bat. I don't know if it was because I was an accident or just something wrong. But it broke right off the bat. And then I decided, you know, I'm going to wait and see what I should get. Because there's the NCE, which is a type of controller where you have, it's about an alert that you have to have at the beginning. And then at the point I did not have a layout, plans or anything like that. So I just got one through DigiTrack and this little, I think it was $40 locomotive. And DCC actually, surprisingly, this thing drives without any power. The power stored in it is actually drives itself. So this, I'll be making a video on this thing, on like how it runs and all that. How the thing runs, how it looks, the quality of it. Now I only have 3 engines so far. And let's see, I have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven frame powers. Not a lot. And 3 engines. Wait, no, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight freight cars counting, caboose, and 3 engines, and the Montana rail link is just in it. So I just want to do a quick little update video on how I'm doing and all that. So I'll do it. I have been wanting to do a garden tractor video, but my stuff has not been starting, and it's pretty cold outside, which I do not want to stay in the cold. So yeah.